you want to measure S parameters, then you need a network analyzer, and the very first step to take is a calibration. In this video, I will show you how to do a one-port calibration with an HP8720C vector network analyzer. When we measure the S parameters of a circuit, the measurement is perturbed by the influence of cables and the own instrument non-idealities. A calibration simulates a perfect network analyzer system with ideal cables. It measures the magnitude and phase responses of known standard devices and compares the measurement with actual device data. Then it uses the results to characterize the system and effectively remove systematic errors with a mathematical model implemented in the analyzer hardware. You should calibrate only after at least 30 minutes of warm-up time to let the instrument reach a good thermal stabilization. We control the analyzer with front panel keys and soft keys. The specific function of each soft key depends on the menu you choose with the front panel keys. I will start by pressing this green key labeled User Preset. It allows you to return the analyzer to a known condition. This condition is defined in a set of variables stored in one of the registries reserved to recover the instrument state. It is the registry number 5. It is a registry that can be modified by the user. If you have problems recovering a known instrument state, you can also press Recall key, and then the soft key named Recall Factory Preset to return to the factory default condition. Now we specify the frequency range. You can use either the panel start-stop keys or the center span keys. We will use start-stop. Let us choose a start frequency of 50 MHz. Since this is the default one, we will just check it by pressing start. We want to measure up to 8 GHz. We press stop, and then 8. And then the units, this time is gigahertz. We can do a more robust and reliable measurement if we enable the averaging utility. To do this, we press the AVG key, and then set the averaging to ON with the corresponding soft key. The ON word becomes uppercase. A total of 16 measurements are then performed and averaged for each single frequency. You can increase the number of measurements by setting a different averaging factor, for instance 32 or 64, but if you do so, the measurement time might increase quite a bit. Next step, I press the calibration key, and then the soft key calibrate menu. Then we specify S11 one port, and the one port calibration menu is shown. The network analyzer displays a message asking us to connect the standards. The calibration kit contains three different standards, a short circuit, an open circuit, and a matched load. Therefore, we need to do three measurements. We don't need to follow any particular sequence. Let us start with the short. Mechanical calibration kits used to come with a calibrated torque wrench. Let us see how to use it. Proper torque on the connector improves measurement repeatability. We hold the torque wrench lightly at the end of the handle and tighten until the breakpoint of the torque wrench is reached. It is particularly important that you rotate only the connector nut, not the device or connector body. The connectors might be damaged if the male center pin is allowed to rotate in the female contact fingers. The connection of the standards is a critical step. High frequency connectors must be handled with care. A damaged connector can damage other connectors. After connecting the standards, I press short, and the instrument starts the first measurement. Okay. After the measurement, the label short becomes underlined. I will connect now the open. We call it open, but it is not a true open. It is very difficult to build an open circuit at high frequencies due to radiation losses. This standard is just a short transmission line terminated with a capacitor. Now I press open and the instrument starts the second measurement. And the label open becomes underlined. The last one is the matched load. We connect it and press loads. And then broadband. This standard is called broadband load to distinguish it from other standards that work in narrower frequency bands. The measurement has finished. We press done. Now all the labels are underlined. Now we press done again and the instrument starts to compute the calibration coefficients. The calibration was finished. Now the label core is displayed at the left of the screen to indicate that we are seeing a corrected measurement. The display is showing us the magnitude of S11 in logarithmic scale. An ideal measurement of a perfectly matched load would lead to a magnitude of S11 equal to zero, and this is minus infinity in decibels. It is for this reason that we are seeing an horizontal line at the bottom of the display. After the calibration, the instrument displays the soft keys of the save menu. We can save the calibration coefficients in one of the registries. We only need to choose one of them. If we choose registry 5, the instrument state and calibration data will be automatically recalled during power on or after pressing the preset key. Now we are ready to measure.